I think you all got the EC12 Corinthian Spirit as part of your email, and hopefully you read through that. I don't anticipate any problems, but the Queen City Model Yacht Club has spent a couple of years and an awful lot of effort to create a great rapport with our venue here, and we don't want to do anything in this weekend that would jeopardize that, and we don't want to do anything that would jeopardize the fun of all the people that showed up. So I'll be a pretty iron hand in terms of controlling that situation. The sailing instructions talk about a 4-point penalty, but it would not end there. A major offense will result in a DS2, which is not, you can't use it as a throwout. Probably a second offense will ask you to leave the regatta. But I don't think that's going to be an issue, but I will deal with it if it becomes one. We're going to start our races at 10 o'clock, both days. We're going to be starting, it looks like, down on the far end of the race course. The course will be a windward, leeward, and then back halfway through the course on windward finish. So windward, leeward, windward with the offset marks. The starting situation will be, we will be starting between the green and white buoy and the red buoy. Okay? We're going to use a system where at the 1 minute mark the line goes hot. If you cross the line, you have to go past the extremity and around one of the end marks. Anybody got that?
Hey Bob, is it one lap or two? Is it 1.5 laps or 2 laps?
You start at that end, for example, you come up to the windward end, return to the leeward end, and then finish in the middle. So it's one. Sort of a 1.5.
1.25.
1.25 laps, I guess you could say.
Right.
So windward, leeward, windward, same thing we did yesterday with our practice. All right. Let's see. And the course diagram is as shown here. The active part of the buoy will be the course side of the buoy for both starting and finishing. One of the most important things, of course, is where are the restrooms? They're right there, and they are functional. Scoring, we're using the tweet system, which is an odd, even two-fleet system, and it's a low-point scoring system. The critical thing here is that you pay attention to which heat you're in. In a particular race, we've got to keep the right boats on the water at all times, and you need to pay attention so you can keep the regatta moving. I suggest that if you're in the first heat of a race, you pull your boat out when you're done. If you're in the second heat and you know that you finished in an odd position, you can leave your boat in the water because you'll be starting immediately. Who's in which heat, which boat numbers are in which heat, so that you'll have a heads up, and I'll have a sheet as well, so you can contact me to see which heat you're in. We won't have that information until the computer spits it out, so we'll go as quickly as we can from the finish of the second heat to the computer, and then spit the sheet out, and then that information will be available. We will allow one delay per individual for regatta, so if you're in a situation where you need a 5-minute delay, you can request that from me. Once per regatta, not once per day, so try to keep those to a minimum. If we have 19 people delaying it, we're not going to do a lot of racing. There's one correction to the sailing instruction under marks. It says there is no penalty for not making a penalty turn unless the offended skipper files an official protest. We're going to try to keep official protests to a minimum here. Let's resolve our situations on the water. If we bog the whole system down with a bunch of protests, it's not going to be a lot of fun for anybody. So, you know the rules. If you don't know the rules, avoid other boats. But assuming you know the rules, take your turn when you should be taking your turn. And go on. Let's have some fun out here and sail to the rules. One thing I didn't mention on the start, there's a zero tolerance for being over. You know, you don't get an inch. If I detect that you're over, you'll be recalled. If a bunch of boats are over, we're going to have to recall the whole race, because it's going to be very difficult for me to see three sail numbers back and call the individual boats. But I have a whistle. If you hear one blast, somebody is over. Two blasts is a general recall, so form up for another start. One thing that worked very well at Nationals last year, and I think is championed by our national champion, Steve, and that is good conversation among skippers during the race. It helps an awful lot if you can let the guy standing next to you know, I'm about to tack on the starboard, or when you enter the zone, you're four boats out, has to have some conversation as to whether or not you have rights. Let's not just barge in there and have a big disaster. Another thing that will help keep conflict to a minimum is, at the windward mark, allow a little bit of extra to windward, overstand it slightly if you possibly can if you're in a big group of boats, because with these shifty winds, inevitably you're going to get headed between where you are and where you get to the mark. And then when you get five boats pinching in there and no water between them, it's a bit of a disaster. So if you put a little water between you and the other boat, sail fast and clean, and then it'll make things a lot easier for everybody. Let's see if I have any more. Redress will be issued if it's deemed appropriate. We have a lot of obstructions here. The whole shoreline is a major obstruction, so give your, and I will note that if you do get into the rocks, it's hard to get out. I mean, and you're probably going to be stuck, and you're going to have to get a pole or something and get the boat off the rock. So if you do that, we are allowing boats to be, you can rescue your boat, but you cannot give yourself an advantage, obviously. You can't shove it towards the next mark, but you can get it off the rocks. There are a number of poles along the way here that you can grab and help get your boat situated and into the water again. If you're, because we have this long shoreline, it's very likely you'll have boats calling for an obstruction as they approach it. So be aware of that. And it may be a multiple boat situation where the request has to be made, the acknowledgement, and then that boat may in turn have to request another boat down the line. So don't wait till the last moment to all of a sudden, oh, I need room, and flop over and throw somebody on the starboard tack. It's crazy.
Did you mention hot and cold
marks? No, I didn't. Good question. Hot and cold marks. The yellow buoys on the outside are cold, so you can't touch those with no penalty. The inner buoys, the green and white buoys, are hot. On the starting line, both buoys are obviously hot. If you finish, which means that any portion of your boat crosses the line from the course side, you are technically finished. But if you hit the mark before you clear the starting line, you have to go return to the course side of the mark, do your turn, and then finish legally, okay? That's about all I have on my list, unless there are some questions.
You want to call out the finishes?
Well, I'm going to be calling the finishes. Yeah. To